So how often does stuff like this happen?
I guess with a fair, you know, a fair amount of frequency, considering the age of the aircraft and how much we use it.
Yeah. So how's it going? What's it looking like?
It's fixed.
Fixed?
Fixed.
One, roger. Traffic is the caravan touching down, rolling up.
Rocket 12-6, come on.
Another aircraft, Casa 212-10 Southwest. About 2 minutes ago, runway 10.
Proper progression is not required.
C-1 copy, traffic, I'll be holding here.
4 takeoff checks when you get them.
In progress, engineer, I'll call on complete.
Roger. There'll probably be a little bit of a delay. I do have two IFR aircraft inbound, one here in about 5 minutes, and the second one should be a little ways out there. I'll make your clearance request.
No radio, C-1.
How was the flight?
Flight was great. Flight was great. Saw a bunch of muskox. Hey guys, how are we doing? I'm going to get things for me around right back.
First of all, it's a pleasure to be here. In the 3 years that I've been Commandant, I've made an annual trip up to Alaska and to the North Slope. And for the last 3 years, we've been trying to bring our equipment up here, see how it operates, see what the limitations are, and also trying to define requirements for what we're going to need to do in the future. There's water where there didn't used to be, and we're responsible for it. The assets you see behind you have been deployed up here, and we need to have a very critical analysis of whether or not they're actually adequate to the task. We know in some cases we need different types of assets potentially. We have challenges up here with navigation, communications, and other things, but we don't know exactly what we need until we get up here and we actually test the equipment with our people. What you see here before you is really Team USA. I really got the idea to do this back in January, and I was talking to Carol Browner, the climate and energy czar for President Obama. We happened to meet each other at an event, and I talked about maybe bringing a group of people up to the North Slope, and I'm gonna have each one of them introduce themselves in a minute and who they are representing in the administration. I thought it was very important that we take a whole of government approach to what's going on up here. The Coast Guard has a large role, of course, and we've been here since Alaska was acquired and the Revenue Cutter Service first brought help and assistance to the natives that lived up here. But beyond that, I think this is such a vast area, so critically important to our environment and to world climate and so forth, that you need to get a much broader scope than just what the Coast Guard mission set is. And for that reason, I'm delighted that we have a series of senior leaders that have offered to come up here, take a look at what's going on, actually walk the talk, walk the ground, if you will. Meet with the mayors and find out exactly what the conditions are up here. So for that reason, number one, I'm extraordinarily grateful for our Coast Guard people that are here. And Rear Admiral Chris Colvin, who's the new 17th District Commander, is with us. He relieved Admiral Gene Brooks just a few weeks ago. And we are here to have conversations, to listen, to understand what the local needs are, where we potentially have operational gaps, so we can move forward and try and make recommendations to our policymakers on how we want to position ourselves, whether it's forward operating locations or different types of equipment that might operate up here.
Alaska Kodiak, Coast Guard 1704, request you secure our guard at this time. We are on approach into Anchorage. How copy?
1704, this is Comstay. Roger, you're on our final approach to Anchorage. I secure your guard at minute 09. Over.
Comstay Kodiak, Coast Guard 1704, Roger, that's a good copy. I will talk to you tomorrow.
Can you lift that up?
Snickers Tower 1704, 2 mile final, runway 7 right.
Coast Guard 1704, Snickers Tower approach 10 wind, 200 at 5, runway 7 right, clear to land.
Clear to land 1704.
About to maintenance 754, can you continue via Kilo? Can you make that right turn on Delta and then text via 7 left to exit at Charlie parking?
Clear to land. Minimum 30-20-04. Little bit slow. There's 100 knots.
That's cute.